Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In previous video, we dealt with clause. We talked about what a clause is, and how we can identify it. Now, in this video, we'll talk about the elements of a clause. What are the elements of a clause? A clause has six main elements. When we think of a clause, it has six main elements. Number one element, it has subject. Subject is a noun or a pronoun or a noun phrase. He, she, it, bus, etc. These can be subjects. And this subject usually comes before the verb in statements. In statements, it comes before the verb. When there is a statement and we have to identify the subject, subject will always be in statements, it will always be before the verb. And second most important element, another element, all the six are have it their own importance. Second element is verb phrase. Lives, love, left, is going, extra. These are verbs. These are verbs and this is called a verb phrase. This is also in clause. It can be one word or more than one words. Is going, it can be a verb phrase. Left can be a verb phrase. Has gone can be a verb phrase. Lives, love can be a verb phrase. And this verb phrase, it forms the central part of a clause, and verb phrase can be one or more words, as is the case with a phrase. A phrase is a unit of grammar, and it can be one word or more than one word. It is a unit of grammar. It can be more one word or more than one word. Third important point is object. Object is it comes after the verb in statements. It follows the verb in statements. It can be the glass, it can be Sohail, it can be Samson, her, him, me, them. It can be them. It can be them, T-H-E-M, them. It can be us, etc. And it can be, normally speaking, it can be any noun or any pronoun. And usually it follows the verb in statements. It follows the verb. It comes after the verb. Another most important element, fourth element, is complement. Complement can be an adjective or a noun. It can be a noun phrase or an adjective phrase. It can be a noun or an adjective. Complement. Complement can be a noun or an adjective. It can be one of the two. It can be a noun, it can be an adjective, complement. And complement, how can we identify a complement and an object? Complement normally deals with the subject. It comes after the verb, but it refers back to the subject. It complement. It is a complement. It refers back to the subject. It talks about the subject. It can be a noun phrase or it can be an adjective phrase. For example, I will write a sentence. He looks good. He looks good. He looks smart. He looks good. This good, it refers to he. This is an adjective and it is a compliment. She is very pretty. Very pretty, it refers to she. And it is compliment. Therefore, it is compliment because it refers back to the subject. He was elected captain. He was elected the captain. The captain refers to he. So, it is a subject. It is a compliment because it refers back to the subject. And this also follows the verb phrase. Compliment also follows the verb phrase. And sometimes it usually follows the object. Sometimes it follows the object. Normally it follows the verb phrase. And the most important element is adverbial. Adverbial phrase. Adverb. Adverb can be for, F-A-R for, W-A-L well, tomorrow, in school. A question, the words which answer where and when. The words which answer where and when are called adverbs. For example, in school. In school is an adverbial bit. Because it answers where. Where did you meet him first? I met him in school. Here is the answer. In school answers the question word where. So in school will become an adverbial. It will become an adverbial. It is adverb. It is adverb. It comes after other elements in the clause. And the subject, verb, object, complement. And after that, For example, suppose a sentence is a subject, verb, object, complement, and after that will come adverb here. And conjunction. Conjunction, as you know, it begins a clause. It is not always needed. It begins a clause. It is not always needed. It can be and, or, if, when, although, though, as soon as, so that, who, which, or where, whose, home. These can be conjunctions, and they are not, or they are not always needed. They are written sometimes. Sometimes they are not written, and they normally begin a clause. These conjunctions, they begin a clause. They are also called connectors or linking words. They begin a clause. So these are some conjunctions. Now I will write a sentence here. Dina gave her daughter. Dina gave her daughter a necklace. If we look at this, Dina is subject because it comes before the verb. It is a statement. It comes before the verb. Dina is subject. So it is subject. Gave is verb phrase, VP verb phrase. Her daughter is object. And necklace is also an object. So this sentence has two objects. Her daughter and necklace. Necklace is direct object. It is direct object because this is the position of Dina. This is possessed by Dina. She gives it to her daughter. So this is direct. First, this comes first, and after that, this is indirect. This object is used because of this. If it had not been there, she would not give anything to her daughter. So, this is a necklace, is direct object, and this is indirect object. Indirect object. Now, Dina gave her daughter a necklace. This is Dina is subject, gave is a verb phrase, her daughter is indirect object, her necklace is direct object. Same is it, it's the same way I will write another sentence, so I will write one more sentence. He was elected captain in 1986. He is subject, S, was elected is verb phrase, VP, captain is complement because it refers back to subject, it is in this person, it is not something else, complement, and in 1986 it answers the question when, so it is adverbial. Because a question, something that answers when and where is called adverbial. So this is about clause. This is about types of clause. These are the types of clause that we normally use in a clause. And remember one thing, a clause doesn't possess all the clauses. It is not so that the clause should have all the elements. It can have only one. When there is only one element, we know the central element of a clause is verb phrase, so it can be verb. It will come. It is a complete clause. It is a complete sentence also, because one clause, there should be at least one clause in a sentence. So come. Come is a clause. Come is a clause. It is a finite verb. It gives meaning, complete meaning. So it is a clause and it makes one sentence. So it is a principal clause. Come, go. These are clauses. So, well, we will look at something else that is called finite verb. It is a verb. It is a verb which is used in present tense and past tense forms. It is a verb which is used in present tense and past tense forms. Finite verb is a verb which is used in present tense and past tense forms. present tense forms and past tense forms. For example, goes, it's a present tense form, it is past tense form, went, these are finite verbs. Go is the same way, go also has past tense form, went, so it is a finite verbs. Do and does, both are finite verbs because they are first forms, and did, this is also a finite verb because this is past form. These are present tense forms. These are past tense forms. So, all verbs except past participle forms, all verbs except past participle forms, and present participle forms, What is past participle form? Normally we say third form of verb is past participle, although third form of verb is not a grammatical term, but for the benefit of students, for common understanding, we use this third form of verb, and this is past participle, and ing form of verb, when we add ing form of verb, this is present participle. For example, third form of verb, write, wrote, written. Written is third form of verb. This is a non-finite verb. And writing, this is also non-finite verb. These are non-finite because these don't show time. Present tense and past tense shows time. Present tense forms and past tense forms are finite verbs. And past participle forms and present participle forms are non-finite verbs. We have to remember this. And after that, what we have to remember? After that, we have to remember one more thing. What is that? That is a verb which follows to, for example, to plus basic form of verb. And this basic form of verb is normally called infinitive. If a verb is followed by to, it is infinitive and it is also non-finite verb. A verb which follows to is non-finite verb. To plus basic form of verb is non-finite. So to infinitive is non-finite verb. We have to remember this thing also. And we have to remember one more thing here. Why I am telling you finite verb and non-finite verb? Non-finite verbs. These are non-finite verbs. These the things that I have placed in this box, they are non-finite verbs, all of them are non-finite. So why I am telling you this? This is because past participle form, present participle form plus and to plus basic form of verb, to plus infinitive, these are also non-finite verbs. For example, to go, to walk, etc. There is also one more example, bare infinitive, that will come later when we move forward. For the time being, you will remember this. So these are non-finite verbs, and non-finite verbs don't show time. Finite verbs show time. So this thing has to be kept in mind when we move forward. So a finite verb, a clause can have more than one verbs. But when it has more than one verbs, one verb must be finite. If it has only one verb, it must be finite. There is no doubt about that. One verb, if there is only one verb in a sentence, it must be finite. But suppose there are more than one verb in a sentence, and there will be only in a clause. There are more than one verb in a clause. A clause is not possible without a finite verb. But suppose there are two or three verbs in a clause. The first verb that will be written first from left side, normally from which place we start a sentence in English, the first verb will be finite. Second and third, they will not be finite, they will be non-finite. But first verb will definitely be finite. So this thing has to be kept in mind while dealing with types of clauses. So clauses, on the basis of clauses, we get simple sentences. Simple sentences. Simple sentence contains one clause, one main clause. We'll do it. And compound sentences and complex sentences. We get these kinds of sentences. Simple sentence, compound sentence, and complex sentences because of these three, because of these types of clauses, we get these three kinds of sentences. What these sentences are, what is a simple sentence, what is a compound sentence, what is a complex sentence, we'll do it in next lecture, in next video. Till then, fi amanillah, khuda hafiz, wish you all the best. I learn this topic, and inshallah we will meet in the next video. Thank you. Till then,